Hi, how are you doing? Welcome to my channel. I'm very glad to have you here. Today, I'm going to be teaching you a very easy way to make tigernut flour meal. So this is like going to serve as an alternative to your paps, to your cereals and other things that you used to have your... your akara, your moi moi, or other things that you use gari, use cereal for. And it's very good because this particular meal, tigernut flour meal, is very, very, very nutritious. It has just natural sugar. You do not need to add any artificial sugar to sweeten it. And if you want to add, you can add dates. It's very nutritious and extremely high in fiber. So if you think that you don't have enough fiber in your meal, you don't have enough dietary fiber, you're dealing with constipation, you want to ease your digestion, tigernut flour meal is the perfect way to do it, to have that. And in today's recipe, I'm just going to be using a very easy recipe. I'm going to be using the tigernut flour and I'm going to be using my soy milk powder. It's very easy, it's very straightforward and highly nutritious. I generally don't use milk to make my food because I can't take dairy because of some allergies. But if you want to use milk in yours, it's going to be yummier, it's going to be sweeter, you can go ahead and use milk. But I don't take milk, so this recipe that I'm using is very perfect for vegans, for vegetarians, and for everybody, and it's highly nutritious. So the first thing you're going to be doing is you're going to be measuring out whatever tigernut flour you want to use. In this particular video, I'm using tigernut flour from Aga's Wholesome. The one I've been getting from them before had dates, so they had the tigernut mixed with dates, which is the one in the plastic jar that I have. But I decided to get pure tigernut flour because I wanted the less sweeter version. So you can go ahead, get your tigernut flour and add dates, or you can get tigernut flour already mixed with dates, or you can just use pure tigernut flour. It's still already sweet, so it doesn't really matter. It just depends on your preference. They are all nutritious. So the first step for me is to measure up my tigernut flour, and I'm going to be using 1/2 cup of tigernut flour for myself. So this is the particular tigernut powder, the one that was mixed with it. That's it, and I'm going to mix them together. I just wanted to show you that. Next, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to measure out 2 tablespoons of soy milk powder. I use better than milk soy powder. I'm going to show you the one I use at the end of this video, or towards the end of this video. That is the only soy milk powder that I've tasted and I really liked. I got it on Amazon. I'm just going to show you how the real package looks like at the end of this video. So I measured out 2 tablespoons before I go ahead and get my tigernut meal prepared. So I'm gonna go ahead and now make this tigernut meal on fire. You can decide to use room temperature water, or you can decide to use hot water. If you use hot water, the whole process will be faster because you would have boiled it and then you will use it. But I'm using room temperature water because I just didn't think about it. I was quite lazy, so the process is just going to take a bit longer. So when you add your room temperature water, you just keep stirring it till the whole thing cooks. You just keep stirring it, adding water. So I added 3 parts of water, that is to whatever, to the amount of tigernut meal I'm using. So I used 1.5 cups because I use 0.5 tigernut meal. So if you are using 1 cup of tigernut meal, you can use 3 cups of water. But sometimes it's always ideal. The ideal is to use maybe 1.25, you get, because what, as you can see, it's getting thicker, so you need to add more water. And the thing about tigernut meal is that it's quite elastic. It's a very elastic meal, so it gets more solidified in room temperature. So if you don't want something that will be too strong, just make sure you add a generous amount of water so that you enjoy it. As you can see, it's very slimy, not very slimy, but it's very sticky, let me put it that way. So just make sure you add enough water to suit your taste. So with what I have now, I just make sure I add more till I get what I want, and yeah, that's basically it. So it's cooked right now, but I'm not okay with the quantity of water. I just keep adding the amount of water I'm okay with, and yeah, once I'm done, I'll be fine. I ended up adding 1.133 parts. So this is the final look of my tigernut meal at room temp. I mean, at hot temperature. This is not a room temperature. It's gonna get thick at room temperature. So it depends on basically your preference, how you like it. But just know that this thing gets very thick at room temperature. The next thing for you to do is now to go and add water to your whatever kind of milk you are using. I'm using the plant-based milk, which is the soy milk powder, which is you know, very healthy, good for people that are lactose intolerant, that have milk allergies. And I just basically add like half part of water to the milk. So basically also just add water to suit your whatever thickness of milk you're comfortable with. I'm going to go ahead and show you the milk I use. So this is the milk I'm using. It's called Better Than Milk Soy Original. I've been using this particular milk for let's just say about 7 years as my milk replacement, my milk alternative. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the milk to my tigernut meal, and it's just gonna be ready, easy peasy, very nice, very yummy, very healthy, perfect for people that are lactose intolerant. Also good for people with milk allergies. Look at how beautiful it looks. That's the final look. Yeah, so nice, so yummy, so delicious. Yeah, so just get it on, have fun, enjoy it. You can also go ahead and pair it with your, you know, with your moi moi, your akara, your whatever it is that you take cereal with. Go ahead and eat guilt-free. So I'll see you in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe.